All right, everyone. We have some news and announcements for Raid Shadow Legends. Actually, some pretty exciting stuff. We have a decent amount to get into. Let's just go ahead and start off with number one on the list, though. And if you go to the news section, you'll see here at the top, the Void Rush is coming. Double chances for Epics and Legendaries. From 08 UTC Friday, January 10th, to 0 UTC Monday, January 13th, we're doubling your chances of receiving Legendary and Epic Champions from Void Charts. Don't miss out on your best chance yet to get a powerful Void Champion. Good luck and happy summoning. Just a little added extra confirmation as well. This was posted in the official Raid Shadow Legends Discord server from community manager Cirilla. Hi guys, it's been a while since my last message here. You may have already seen the news in the game, but I wanted to let you know here as well. We will launch times two chances to pull Epics and Legendaries from Void Shards tomorrow together with the Summon Rush event. Keep your eye on the portal. And I know that this one specifically is an event that I've been waiting for a while because I actually skipped out on the last Void times two rates event. And right now I have 40 Void Shards saved up on my account. That's right, 40. So you guys can definitely expect a very big Void Shard summoning video coming really soon. Definitely keep your eyes on the channel for that. It'll probably be tomorrow or the next day at the very latest. But combined with an upcoming Summon Rush as well, you'll see that in the events page right here. You should get the points. I don't know how big they're going to make the Summon Rush. Lately, what they've actually been doing is whenever a Summon Rush event or a Champion Chase event comes out tied together with one of these times two rate events, they've actually made it really big. Whereas normally these events are, you know, 3,000, 4,000 points. It wouldn't really surprise me if this one was something like 6,000 points or maybe even more because there is a Void event tied along with it. They really want to get you to summon as many shards as possible. But definitely make sure that you guys summon when both of these are active at the same time. Plarium might do a typical Plarium thing, and one of these might activate an hour or two earlier than the other. Like the Void Rush might activate first, or the Summon Rush might activate first. Definitely wait at least a few hours. Make sure they're both active. And as always, whenever it comes to summoning events, make sure that the new animations are on the portal. And when you actually go to the summoning screen, you click on the little rates icon, you'll see it all over the screen, but it should be the Void highlighted here with the rates doubled. So your chance to get Epics will be 16% and your chance to get Legendaries will be 1%. Absolutely make sure that this is active just in case there's any kind of a delay, or maybe you're in a weird time zone or there's some sort of server problems, because you don't want to summon all your shards and realize that you didn't actually get the boost to those double rates. So always double check. Now, something else that I always like to say, just as a little piece of advice, whenever stuff like this happens, summoning typically doesn't really take that long. You know, how long is it really going to end up taking to pull 40 Void Shards? Maybe 10, 15 minutes or so. Even if you have more than I do, it's probably not going to take more than half an hour or so. Maybe you have to manage your inventory a little bit. So if you want to err on the side of caution, you could always wait until the last day of these events just to see if Plarium does anything else. Maybe they introduce a Champion Chase alongside with the Summon Rush. Maybe they introduce some other summoning event. You don't have to do it, but it is just a piece of advice because I know in the past, Plarium has announced additional summoning events on the last day of previously running stuff. I don't think that they're going to do it now that they've already announced that a Summon Rush is going to run alongside it. But before, when they used to do events that didn't run alongside other events at the same time, they would do that. So they would introduce, say, for example, a times two Ancient Shard, and then on the very last day of that, they would say, okay, now there's a Champion Chase tournament coming out as well. So it was a little bit scumbaggy. They seem to have been doing it a little bit less, but you know, if you guys always want to be super careful and just be 100% safe, that's another piece of advice that I can offer you guys right there. So that's going to be everything about the Void Rush. And like I said, keep an eye out on the channel because I will be doing a major summoning video with 40 plus Void Shards coming up real soon. Now, the next thing on the list is going to be in the tournament section. So I didn't think that this was really that big of a deal at first because we have an Ice Golem tournament. You know, we just had a Spider tournament. I think we had a Dragon tournament the day before, something along those lines. But when I looked at it, there are a couple of things that stood out to me. First of all, the rewards are better than the Spider tournament. You'll see that you've got a 5-star chicken, whereas the Spider tournament did not have a 5-star chicken. I didn't even participate in it. Sure, it had an epic book, but besides that, if you look at the rewards, they seemed pretty lackluster. The Ice Golem Tournament, the rewards seem a little bit better. You've got an XP boost, 70 gems, 5-star chicken, clan boss key at the top. You've got some gems, some energy refills, still only 4 epic artifacts. But that's not even the thing that really stood out to me. I always now have been looking at the global leaderboards to see what's going on there, and I saw that in the Ice Golem Tournament, they are actually offering a champion for first place. It's gonna be a Skull Crusher. Now, they've been doing this a lot with the Champion Chase tournaments, but that's a tournament where you actually have to use shards in order to summon, and it's going to be very, very difficult to compete for that one if you don't spend a lot of money on the game. This tournament, though, might be a little bit more realistic because you don't have to spam summon shards to get points. You have to farm an actual piece of content in-game. Still probably going to be difficult to compete if you don't refresh your energy a lot. You probably don't have a lot of resources to do so, but I don't believe they've done a reward where they've offered a champion for one of these non-summoning type tournaments before. I could be wrong, but Skull Crusher for first place is definitely interesting. Now, when it comes to epics, the thing is, I think a lot of people who are going to be competing for first place for a lot of these tournaments, they're probably already going to have a lot of decent epics. Skull Crusher is a really good choice because he's actually going to be one of the best epics in terms of how useful he is. So if they were to pick a champion to give out as a reward for one of these kinds of tournaments, I think Skull Crusher was probably one of the better choices. But, you know, who knows how this will turn out? Who knows how many points people will have at the end of this? Overall, Ice Golem is not typically farmed as much as things like Dragon and Spiders, so it does make sense that they try to entice people with the rewards maybe a little bit more to try to get people to end up running this stuff. So that's going to be the Ice Golem tournament. You have almost 4 full days running on that. Now, in terms of events that are ending, if we go to the events section, you guys will see here the Arena Assault. We've still got about 2 days on this. Now, unfortunately, this Arena Assault, it was 950 points, which was the same amount of points that you needed for the last Arena Assault. The problem is this one is only a 4-day Arena Assault, whereas I believe the last few have been 7 or 8 days, making this way more difficult for free-to-play. Getting 950 points in the Arena Assault in 4 days... very, very difficult, pretty much impossible if you don't actually use gems or arena bags to refresh your tokens. And I could safely say I'm at 616 points. I have not only been using my free tokens, I've actually been using some old arena bags that I've saved up for a while. So, you know, this has even been a bit of a stretch. Somebody who is actually using resources to try to do this event. The good news is the rewards are not so insane that if you miss out, it's really a big deal. No legendary book, nothing really too crazy, just 1 ancient shard, a few gems, a little bit of energy. So if you don't get everything, it's not that big of a deal, but definitely going to be very difficult, if not near impossible, for people who don't use their resources. Champion training event as well. We've got about a week and a half, maybe a little bit more than that left, getting close to all the points. The good news as well is you guys, if you've been doing this every single day since it came out, you should actually get those 2 void shards just in time for the void event that we have going on right now. Still got about another week or so before I get all the rest of the rewards from this, including that sacred shard. So this has been an interesting event. I do like how they increased the daily points earning from 150 to 225, made it a bit easier. So now you can be okay with missing a couple days here and there. And the last thing on the actual agenda for today is Polarium has been gone for a while. I don't know if you guys have noticed this, but it has been very slow in Raid Shadow Legends over the last 2 weeks or so. Not only what the actual shop offers, which is something I talked about a little bit in some videos a few days ago, but also just in terms of announcements and in-game content. There really hasn't been a lot going on since that Tormund fusion ended. Well, this is going to change. Now that Polarium seems to actually be back in the office, got this void shard going on right now, but Cirilla mentioned, of course, in that original post here about the void event that she is back, and it seems like we're going to start to be getting some more stuff coming up real soon. So definitely keep your eyes out for in-game news, updates, and all that stuff, because I am hoping that it'll start to ramp up now that we are getting into the month of January and the holidays are kind of wrapping up. Now, speaking of last-minute updates, there was a very minor one posted around the same time that they announced this Void Rush right here in the Discord server. Cirilla mentioned just catching up on writing here for all the time that I missed, guys. We will need to restart the server in about 25 minutes at 12 p.m. UTC. This has to do with decreasing the attack speed and HP for one of the campaign bosses, the Durham Forest boss on normal difficulty. It wasn't very well balanced for new players, so we fixed it. This will make the fight a bit more accessible. The downtime won't be long. So Durham Forest is going to be one of the campaign stages. It's going to be, I believe it is, let's see, Durham Forest. I don't remember. Oh, it's stage 4 right here. So this dragon guy, for newer players, stage 4 normal, still pretty early into the game. Apparently a lot of newer players were having difficulties with that. I don't remember. That was such a long time ago for my account now that I don't remember if I struggled with that part of the game or not. But it's only on the normal difficulty, and it's really not that big of a change. But Plarium is back, and hopefully we start to actually see some updates and news for other things in the game, especially for those of us who are more mid and late game players. So that's going to be the wrap up on everything going on in Raid Shadow Legends for the day. I hope you guys are looking forward to all the fun stuff. I'm definitely looking forward to that Void summoning video. I hope you guys are as well. So definitely keep an eye on the channel. That'll be coming up real soon. And of course, if you guys did enjoy this video and you want more videos like this, consider subscribing to the channel, especially if you're looking forward to that 40 plus Void summoning video. Feel free to like as well. It helps out more than you guys can imagine here on YouTube. And of course, more Raid Shadow Legends videos, guides, tutorials, and all that fun stuff should be popping up on the screen right about now. Over 120 Raid Shadow Legends videos. Feel free to check them out. But if not, until next time, this is Salt of the Salty Guild signing out.